Hello, myself Ruban here. So today we'll be demonstrating how we can connect Rigol oscilloscopes to the PC remotely. So we'll be I'm having Rigol DS1054 along with me, and I'll be taking the remote access for that. So in order to take the remote access, so there is a software which is called as Ultra Sigma, which you need to download it from Rigol site. So I'll just guide you how you can download this software. So first you can just go to rigol.com, okay, and after that you can just click on this search option, and here you can just type Ultra Sigma, okay, then it will take to this page, and you can just download this Ultra Sigma PC installer. Okay, so as soon as you click on this software, so it will start downloading the software, which is here. Okay, so currently we have already downloaded this software and we have installed the software, so that's the reason we won't download it again. Okay, so after installing, so this will look somewhat like this. After installing, Ultra Sigma will be there. So yeah, I'll just open the software. So after opening this software, there will be a screen in which it will be showing that how many instruments are connected right now, what is the type of instrument connection. Then you can just click on this part also. So here you can just click on this manual input LAN instrument if you have selected any fixed IP, or if you want to connect any normal IP. Like right now none of the instruments are connected, so it won't show anything here. So now I am connecting Rigol DS1054 along with this, and I'll just click on search for this. Okay, after clicking search, then there will be instrument, the instrument will be detected here. Okay, so I'll just click on LAN search. So this is the instrument which is connected right now. I'll just click it on OK. Okay, so this is the instrument which is connected. Okay, now we have this Ultrascope software. Okay, so after, when you install this DS1054, this software automatically gets installed here. Okay, so this is the software. I'll just click on search instrument. So please note that before searching this instrument, you need to run this Ultra Sigma before searching here, because it is totally dependent on the Ultra Sigma software. Okay, so this is how, this is the instrument which I have connected, which is DS1054Z. So after clicking on this, I'll just click on OK. So it will take me to another screen which will be showing the details which we have here. Okay, so this is for like the complete screen. Okay, so from this you can easily identify which are the settings which we can do from here. Like I can do the auto set option from here, I can run and stop with the help of this function here. Okay, so as you can see, after pressing this auto set button, the instrument has gone to the auto settings here. And like it has adjusted the volts per division, times per division automatically, and depending on that we are getting this waveform. Okay, so from here you can set the channel settings, like what should be the coupling of the channel, then if I want to limit the bandwidth, the probe setup, if I want to invert the signal, then what should be the units, and acquisition settings are here, like what is the type of acquisition, normal, average, then peak detect, then we have high resolution mode. So these all settings can be occupied from here, and you can set the user, you can set this memory. It is the acquisition memory, like 12 kilo points, 120 kilo points, 1.2 million points, depending on this whatever settings you have acquired. Okay, other than that, you can change the trigger modes, trigger settings from here. So we have actually three modes in this case, like auto, normal, and single sequence. So we can set it from this point, then we can trigger on any of the pulses, like edge, pulse, run, window. The complete setting can be done from this specific trigger panel. Okay, then we can change the source of the trigger as channel 1, channel 2, channel 3. Then we can change the slope type, like whether it is rising, falling, either of the slope. So depending on your application, it will just means it will keep means it will keep changing the settings, whatever settings you've changed from your, then trigger level also, like we can change it from your, like if I consider as 2 volts at this point, so it will set the trigger level to 2 volts in this case. Okay, I can change the scale for channel from here also, like 490 milli. Okay, I can change the same for position also by this knob. Okay, other than that, I can add some functions like A plus B, A minus B. Then it has its dedicated FFT window for the same. If you want to do analysis on the FFT, you can add the start frequency, stop frequency, center frequency, as the signal is 1 kilohertz right now. Okay, so this is my center frequency span. I'll just set it for around 1 kilohertz. Okay, or I can just set it to 10 kilohertz also. So you can just do this analysis part here. Okay, then you can change the window type, whether it is rectangle, hamming, hanning, blacksmith, any of this thing, you can do it from here. Okay, RVW, you can change it from here. Then we have FFT source, whether we want to select channel 1, 2, 3, 4, then we what is the reference level, we can change this reference level with the help of this unit. We can change the start frequency, we can change the stop frequency. So it is having this dedicated window for this. You can take this window anywhere on the screen. When you want to remove it, you can just close it. Okay, other than that, okay, just a minute. So this is a screen, like we can add various measurements. So for measure, we can select the, we can view the readings in this plane. When we click on measure, we can change the source. So as you can see, as soon as I change the source from channel 1 to channel 2, this color becomes blue. This means that we are taking the measurement from channel 2. Then we can add the positive duty, negative duty, rise time, fall time, anything which I want to measure, I can add here. So maximum of 4 readings can be accumulated here. Okay, then we have this reset statistics, then measure setup. So this complete setup of the oscilloscope can be done with the help of this. You can just take, save this screen. The number of screens, how many you want, number of screens, like 2 screens, 3 screens, depending on your requirement, you can just set anything here. Okay, so this is what I have here. Okay, then you can just right click and you can change the Y scale, you can move, you can zoom it, you can place cursors over here. Okay, so like I want to add manual cursors here. Okay, so I can just I'll just add some cursors. Okay, manual cursors. So this will just show the settings for cursor, like if I want to rotate it, I can just move it from any point. And here you can see the X position, Y position of the cursor, then what is the delta value, everything will be shown here. Okay, as soon as I move this, you can see it simultaneously at this place here. Okay, then we have this tracking cursor. Okay, so it will continuously track the voltages or whatever level we have set it to. So this is the thing. Okay, then we have other options, like I want to print this screen, or connected points, enable or disable grid. So these are the settings which I can get it from here. Okay, then I can increase or decrease the times per scale division. Okay, from this point you can see this changes here. Okay, so these are the settings which we can take it from here. Then I can use the default setup, I can use the single sequence, I can use the run, auto, everything can be done from this part. Okay, so now it has went to this default setup here. Okay, and now I'll just click on auto set, and it will automatically set the volts per division, times per division, and other things, and it will just display that. Okay, so now it has came to the auto set position here. So hope I've covered everything which is used in this setup. And if you want to, yes, so this was the thing. Thank you so much for going through this video. Thank you so much.